Several fires continue to burn out of control in Southern California.
And what's the latest on the largest of these fires?
There's very little that can be done to control the spread of that fire.
This is the new reality.
A fire comes in and starts igniting homes from the outside.
Cars in the driveway and homes just charred to bits.
In this very wonderful place, but a place that's getting hot.
It's just that by now the rainy season should have started.
And all it takes is a little spark. Nothing can be considered typical anymore.
But I've never seen anything like this.
The flames and smoke was horizontal.
Compounded by incredibly strong,
powerful wind gusts at nearly tropical storm strength.
Called Santa Ana winds. And
intensity is just too much.
You're fanned by strong wind.
And it really gets these flames going.
Fanning these flames, so to speak.
The flames were driven by the wind.
To driving flames.
And it carries embers miles away and sets out these homes on fire.
Making conditions worse.
Well, the biggest problem is wind. You know, we have these Santa Ana winds in California.
Hurricane force gusts that blow off the Mojave Desert, igniting infernos.
We saw entire neighborhood blocks that were obliterated.
Communities under threat.
And on top of that, because that cap of smoke can't get aircraft in.
The smoke is so bad here that aircraft can't fly.
There's over 1,000 firefighters on the ground and in the air using helicopters and airplanes to drop water and fire retardant on this fire, but again,
the visibility here is really low because of this wind with smoke.
But they blow too hard, aircraft can't be in the air overhead
because they simply can't see it.
Brush is too dense and it's just too steep.
It's too dry, it's too hot, and in December it's snowing white ash.
The smoke, the embers, I mean the flames were 100 foot flames or even bigger.
Looked down the whole back mountain, it was burning behind.
This neighborhood got pretty well scorched from what he said.
And with the flip of a switch or a lever, their entire home within a matter of moments is engulfed.
The blaze.
And it goes like crazy.
Because it's just so dry.
Forecasters say the dry conditions in Southern California will likely continue into January.
An emergency alert warning of extreme fire danger.
I thought that season was over. And it basically, it's going to be Christmas before you know it. It's going to be long.
And that this is just a way of life moving forward here in California.
And that turns out to be the case nationwide.
Before you know it, the whole place goes.
We're facing a new reality in the state where fires threaten people's lives, their property, their neighborhoods, and of course, billions and billions of dollars.
Fire officials tell us that fire season year-round in California is the new normal.
Climate experts say this could be the new normal.
Drought and wildfires are a fixture of daily life.
Much more often.
This year, we experienced a record warmest summer.
And that's mainly because the summers are hotter. But now, fire season is year-round.
And they're actually not expecting it to get any better.
Fire officials tell us that can be attributed to climate change.
Reflecting reality, there's nothing they can do to stop the fires.
Because electricity and water pumps have been affected in some areas.
Wildfires are still growing. The number of large fires multiplied to at least 6.
Then there's also power lines that go down everywhere.
Water, power, sewer lines, everything.
It just does not seem to be economically feasible in the quantities you would have to move it.
It's not working.
The scenes of devastation are just really haunting.
New evacuation orders because of the fire have been issued.
More than 200,000 people have been chased from their homes.
Some were woken up in the middle of the night and told to leave their homes immediately.
It's funny what you see when people are fleeing fires.
Most people are wearing these white protective masks.
Other people are terrified.
We were all just kind of holding our breath.
Under evacuation and stranded for days.
It looked like a war zone.
I pretty well gutted.
Because I knew it would be bad, and it was, you know.
A lot of these wildland fires start in the backcountry where the power companies, the electric companies, have
tumbled since the fires began on Monday, shaving more than $3 billion off the company's market value.
Everybody should get out.
At what point do you decide to evacuate? Then you drive into the city of Ventura, and you have these incredible homes that are on these hillsides, beautiful views of the ocean, and they're burning.
San Diego area alone, more than 1,000 firefighters are on the ground, aided by air tankers and helicopters. To the north, fires continue to burn near Los Angeles.
What we're trying to do is bring fire to a location where we can draw a line in the sand and actually put it out.
So, I thought he was full of baloney, but once I saw the flames and smoke, I thought that maybe he's right.
Have an emergency kit packed at all times
be it for fires, floods, earthquakes.
And I don't really care for that. I don't like that so much.
Because, you know, so they, I mean, they've got to activate the store infrastructure. You know, the infrastructure needs, utility needs there. You know, then people have to get back and see what remains of these neighborhoods.
This is a wildfire that has burned more than 15,000 acres.
Burning 55,000 acres. Burned more than 140,000 acres.
It's burned almost 150,000 acres.
More than 230,000 acres burned.
230,000 acres? We're going to be here for a while. And basically, just put this fire out. Put it out.
But from being on the ground, I can tell you that that number is certainly going to rise.
Thousands and tens of thousands.
About 180 square miles. 360 square miles. Scorched more than 360 square miles. More than 360 square miles. Nearly 370 square miles.
We knew that that number was much higher than that.
The new fire has ignited in San Diego County, which has already been hit by wind-driven wildfire.
It also led to a new fast-moving fire outside of San Diego that burned a racetrack.
The largest, the Thomas Fire, is expected to get bigger and Ventura County.
Millions and millions of wind-driven embers that slam into the house and start igniting the home.
Up close, I've seen wildfires, but I've not seen anything like this.
This year has been a particularly horrible year.
That virtually everyone in the United States is underinsured.
But the huge fire burning in Ventura County, northwest of Los Angeles, continues to grow.
And so it's something that we have to accept about the place that we live. And as the climate changes and we